केसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्तां वो मधुरपोः प्रपन्नार्थच्युतौ नखाः एवम् अलङ्कारध्वनिमार्गं व्युत्पाद्य तस्य प्रयोजनवत्तां ख्यापयितुम् इदम् उच्यते. टिल् नौ हि हेस् गिवन् अस् द डिफ्रेण्ट् सब् डिविजन्स् आफ् ध्वनि एण्ड् उदाहरणम् अलाङ्ग् वित् उदाहरणं हि हेस् गिवन् अस् द ध्वनिमार्गम् अलङ्कारध्वनिमार्गं व्युत्पाद्य. आफ्टर् गिविङ्ग् अस् देट् अलङ्कारध्वनि एक्साम्पल्स् हि इस् जस्ट् द क्वश्चन् दट् वन् केन् हेव् इस् there are so many people who have given alankaras, who have given definitions of alankaras and the examples for alankaras. So what is the speciality in Anandavardhana describing it or giving us vyatireka and all these alankaras now? He's given us so many alankaras now, right? So the one shanka that अभिनव गुप्ता स्टार्ट्स् इस् हि सेस् ननु उक्ताः तावत् चिरन्तनैः अलङ्काराः तेषां तु भवता यदि व्यङ्ग्यत्वं प्रदर्शितं किं यथा इति आशङ्क्य आह. इट्स् वेरि इम्पार्टेण्ट्. सो वै डस् हि सडन्लि से दट् अलङ्कार इस् देर् इस् अ प्रयोजनं फार् अलङ्कार नाट् नेसेसरि रैट्. सो यु हेव् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दट् अवान्तरसङ्गति देर् अण्ड् अभिनव गुप्ता गिव्स् अस् दट् This is there is so many chirantana puratana alankar alankarikaha yahi uktaha alankaraha santi tejam atra pratipadanena kimartham. What is the prayojanam for it, or what is the speciality uniqueness that you have contributed to the world, right, to the alankara world? For that Anandavardhana starts by saying sharirikaranam yesham vachitve na vyavastitam ते अलङ्काराः परां छायां यान्ति ध्वन्यङ्गतां गतः. देर् आर् टु वेस् आफ् इण्टर्प्रिटिङ्ग् द फस्ट् लैन् शरीरीकरणं येषां वाच्यत्वेन व्यवस्थितम् येषाम् अलङ्काराणाम् इन्स्टेड् आफ् स्प्लिट्टिङ्ग् वाच्यत्वे एण्ड् न ऐ एम् टेकिङ्ग् इट् एस् ए सिङ्गल् वर्ड् तृतीया विभक्ति. सो येषाम् अलङ्काराणां वाच्यत्वेन व्यवस्थितं शरीरीकरणम् If those alankaras are vachya, if they are used as a primary meaning or they are vachya alankara, then it is only shariri karanam. It is just adding a mere beauty to the shariram. It is only treated or taken as a part of the shariram, just like kataka, kankana, etc. Abhushanani eva. येषाम् अलङ्काराणां वाच्यत्वेन व्यवस्थापने सति तत्र तेषाम् अलङ्काराणां शरीरीकरणम् एव. यत्र पुनः ते अलङ्काराः ध्वन्यङ्गतां गताः. इफ् दोस् अलङ्कारस् आर् एम्प्लाय्ड् एस् अ ध्वनि अङ्ग ध्वनि अङ्ग यु शुड् टेक् इट् एस् ऐदर् व्यञ्जकत्वेन अथवा व्यङ्ग्यत्वेन. Either it is used, the alankara is used as a vyanjaka, a suggestor, or the alankara itself is being suggested here, vyangyatvena. Dvani angatam gata. Angata means it does not mean that it is a subordinate to the dvani. It is a part of dvani. Here the anga means part. So dvanehe angataya yatra alankaraha upayujyante. In other words, dvanehe eva tatra pradhanyam vartate. तत्र ते अलङ्काराः परां छायां यान्ति. दोस् अलङ्कारास् आर् वेरि ब्यूटिफुल्. दे वेन् दे अटेन् दि हैयेस्ट् फार्म् आफ् ब्यूटि वेन् दे आर् एम्प्लाय्ड् एस् पार्ट् आफ् ध्वनि ऐदर् एस् अ सजेस्टार् ऐदर् एस् अ व्यञ्जक आर् अ व्यङ्ग्य. सो ध्वन्यङ्गता च उभाभ्यां प्रकाराभ्याम् इन् टु वेस् व्यञ्जकत्वेन अथवा व्यङ्ग्यत्वेन. The same prachina ukta alankaranam, what is the difference that you are saying? That was the question that he raised. So the answer will be prachina ukta alankaranam dvanyatmataya yadi vyavasthapanam kriyate tatra adhikam shobham atanoti. So just you can't merely give the definition of an alankara and give the example of an alankara and say it contributes beauty towards the kavyam. You have to be more specific as to where that alankara is placed, either vachyam or vyangyam. So that is the reason why I have shown this Alankara Markam, the Alankara Dhvani Markam. It is not a compendium of definitions and Alankara. It is not an Alankara Shastra. It is a Dhvani, and its placement, what is the placement of Alankaras as far, with respect to Dhvani? That is what I have shown so far, as far as Anandavardhana is concerned. So, Dhvanyangata cha Ubhabhyam Prakarabhyam Vyanjakatvena Vyangyatvena cha Tatra Iha Prakaranat Vyangyatvena Iti Avagantavyam. Prakaranat, in the context, we have shown Alankara Dhvani, where Alankara is a Vyangya. Vyangyatvena Darshitam, Natu Vyanjakatvena. Or actually, Vyanjakam is also there, where one from in the shlokas like Prapta Shrihi, where there is a Vachya, there is an Alankara, Sankara Alankara is there, and then the Vyangyam, there is a Rupaka Dhvani. So, but stress has been given only to the Vyangya Mukham to show us what are all the different Alankaras that can be suggested. So, Vyangya Mukhenaiva Iha Prakaranat Avagantavyam. Vyangyatve Api Alankaranam Pradhanya Vivakshayame Vasatyam Dhvanau Antapataha. Very important. So Vyangyatve Api, even when Alankara is suggested, Pradhanya Vivakshayame, only if the suggested Alankara has more importance, more Pradhanyam to Atra Charutva Visheshaha. Only if there is a more beauty towards that Alankara which is suggested, it can be considered as Dhvani, Dhvanau Antapataha. Itharata tu itharata yatra vyangya alankaranam pradhanyam na vartate tatra gunibhuta vyangyam pratipadayishyate. He is going to conclude this udyota with a small this thing about gunibhuta vyangyam. Okay, so it is only gunibhuta vyangyam if the alankara does not have a pradhanatva iti pratipadayishyate. Angitvena vyangyatayam api alankaranam dvayi gatihi kadachit vastumatrena vyajyate kadachit alankarena. Angitvena, when that alankara is an angi or a pradhanam and it is suggested, that suggested alankara dvani can happen through two processes. Alankaranam dvayi gatihi. Vyangyataya pratibhasamananam alankaranam dvayi gatihi vastuna vyajyate athava alankarena vyajyate. Two ways in which alankara dvani can happen, or the suggestion of alankaras can happen, is either through vastu. Vastu is any fact or a situation or an idea that is being described in the vachyam, and that vachya can give rise to an alankara dvani. Or an alankara itself can give rise to another alankara. Tatra, the karika there is, vyajyante vastumatrena yada alankritayaha tada dhruvam dhvanyangata tasam. Yada alankritayaha alankaraha vastumatrena vyajyante, if they are suggested just by a vastu, dhruvam dhvanyangata tasam alankritinam, those alankaras are definitely a part of dhvani, dhvanyangata dhruvam. Atra hetuhu, so why do you say dhruvam dhvanyangata? What is the reason for that? Kavya vrittihi tadashraya. Tadashraya, alankara, vyangya alankara paratvena eva kavyatva vyavasthapanam. Kavyatva vyapadeshaha. So yasmat karanat, tatra tasmin shloke, tathavidha vyangya alankara paratvenaiva kavyam pravrittam. Only when the alankara is suggested in such a manner that it has more beauty, only there do we say it is kavyam. Otherwise, it is just mere vakyam. Vastu, when you are talking about a fact like devatattaha gacchati, it becomes just a vakyam there. There is no beauty to something which does not gives rise to, or something does not suggest. If there is no suggestion of any sort, then it is just a mere statement. Anyathātu tad vākyamātram yeva syāt. There is no beauty to it. Okay? Tāsāmeva alankritīnām alankārāntara vyangyabhāve when it is alankarena alankaram, alankarantara vyangya bhave punaha dvanyangata bhavet, it becomes again, it is also treated as a part of dvani. So he is just saying how vastuna, just as how vastuna alankara dvani can also happen, in the same manner alankarena alankara dvani also is a, it should be treated as a classification of dvani. Without giving us, you know, point by point or a chart system, he has just written it in the karika form. So alankarantara vyangya bhave, alankarantara vyangya bhave, when one alankara gives rise to another alankara, there also dvanyangata bhavet, charutva utkarshataha vyangya pradhanyam yadi lakshyate. That is the important clause here. Yadi, if vyangya pradhanyam, charutva utkarshataha vyangya pradhanyam, because of the beauty that is there, charutva utkarsha karanat, yadi vyangyasya eva pradhanyam tatra lakshyate, tarhi dvanau antapadaha. Uktabhi etat, charutva utkarsha nibandhana vachyavyangyayoho pradhanya vivaksha. What is the pradhanyam? How do we determine the pradhanyam? Which is more important? Is vachyam important here or vyangyam important here? You have to look at where the charutva utkarshaha is present. Whichever has a greater degree of beauty, whether it is vachyam or vyangyam, the one that has the greater degree of beauty, that has pradhanyam. So if the vachyam is more beautiful than the vyangyam, then the vachyam has pradhanyam. If the vyangyam is more beautiful, then vyangyam has pradhanyam. So vastumatra vyangyatvena, vastumatra vyangyatve cha alankaranam anantara upadarshitebhyaha eva udaharanebhyaha vishayaha unneyaha. Any example that he has so far shown us is only vastuna alankaraha athava alankarantarena alankaraha. He has not shown us how vastu can be vyangyam. That he says you have to use the given examples to understand how vastu can be a vyangyam. Vastu vyangyam you can take as kasivana bhavati rosho is a good example of vastu vyangyam. But he doesn't give any examples. Even in Lochanam, he just says, you look at Prapta Shreer, etc. Those will give you an idea of how Vastu Vyangyam can happen. He doesn't give examples for all that. Vastuna Vastu and Alankarena Vastu. So, Vastu Matra Vyangyatve, when only a Vastu is suggested, that examples should be taken from the already shown examples. Vastu Matra Vyangyatve, alankaranam anantara upadarshitebhyaha udaharanebhyaha eva, whatever udaharanam that we have shown before, vishayaha unneyaha, you have to understand vastu examples also, vastu vyangya examples also. Tadevam arthamatrena alankara vishesha rupena va arthena arthantarasya alankarasya va prakashane charutva utkarsha nibandhane sati arthashakti udbhava anuranana rupa vyangyaha dhvanihi avagantavyaha. If you look at the text, it will say niravagantavyaha. There is a typo there in Lochanam, in some of the editions. It is actually vyangyo dhvanihi avagantavyaha. So, tadevam, in this manner, arthamatrena alankara visheshe rupena arthenava, just by vastu or with an alankaram. Arthamatrena ityukte vastuna athava alankara visheshe rupena va arthena arthalankarena va arthantarasya vastunaha prakashanam athava alankarasya prakashanam. So what happens? Arthamatrena arthantarasya prakashanam is your first variety, which is vastuna vastudvani. Alankara visheshe rupena arthantarasya prakashanam, which is alankarena vastudvani. The next variety will be arthamatrena alankarasya prakashanam, which is vastuna alankaradvani. Alankara visheshe rupena arthena alankarasya prakashanam, which is alankarena alankaraha dhvani, that is the fourth variety of arthashakti udbhava dhvani. Charutva utkarsha nibandhane sati is very clear. When the arthantaram or the alankaram, which is vyangyam, has more beauty, has a greater degree of beauty, then it is arthashakti udbhava anuranana roopa vyangyaha dhvanihi avagantavyaha. Only then should we take it as arthashakti udbhava anuranana roopa category of dhvani. So evam dhvanehe prabedana pratipadhya. So dhvani prabeda is, from the beginning we saw avivakshita vachadhvani and vivakshita anyapara vachadhvani in the first udyotam itself. And when he started second udyotam, he started with atyanta tiraskritam and arthantra sankramitam. Arthantra sankramitam was divided into alakshya krama vyangya and anuranana roopa. Anuranana roopa is commonly known as samlakshya krama, where the krama is known, or anuranam, where it is repeated like an echo. So we know that there is a prathama shabdaha and there is a anuranana shabdaha. So shabda, that is again shabda shakti moolaha, artha shakti moolaha. Ubaya shakti moola is present and it is there. He also said that, okay, here just to show the differences, artha shakti moola is again of three types: kavi prodokti, kavi nibaddha vaktra prodokti and swatas sambhavi. Each of these three are divided further into vastuna vastu, vastuna alankaraha, alankarena vastu and alankarena alankaraha. Evam dhvanev pravedana pratipadya. After giving the different divisions of dhvani, tadabhasa vivekam kartum uchyate. Tadabhasaha. He does not say gunibhuta vyangyam. He only gives the mention of dhvanihi and dhvani abhasaha. It seems as if it is like dhvani. Ishate bhasate iti abhasaha. So it may be considered as dhvani, but it is not dhvani. So dhvanehe vishayaha na kintu dhvanyabhasaha eva. His other word for this by later alankarikas, it has been defined as, or it has been named as gunibhutam vyangyam. Yatra pratiyamanaha artaha pramlishtatvena bhasati vachyasya angatayava api na asya asau gocharaha dhvanehe. Yatra yasmin kavye pratiyamanaha artaha vyangyataya bhasamanaha artaha pramlishtatvena bhasate. Pramlishtatvena asputataya, very indistinct, or it is not as great as how it is in dhvani. So pratiyamanaha artaha yatra, it is very indistinct there. Athava vachyasya angataya vapi, or you have the vachyartham and the vyangyartham is there. The vyangyartham actually gives a support to the vachyartham. Then also it is not dhvani. Na asya dhvanehe gocharaha asau. Asya dhvanehe vachya asya. Sorry, 1 minute. Eppadi adu anvayam aagum paakkara. अस्य ध्वनेः, सारि, अस्य ध्वनेः इत्युक्ते अर्थशक्ति उद्भवस्य अथवा ध्वनि, एनी वेरैटी आफ् ध्वनि यु केन् टेक्. ईस् गोयिङ्ग् टु शो फर् बोत् विवक्षित अन्यपरवाच्यम् एण्ड् अविवक्षित वाच्यध्वनि. सो अस्य ध्वनेः गोचरः असौ न, असौ इत्युक्ते प्रम्लिष्टत्वेन यः अर्थः भासते सः अस्य ध्वनेः गोचरः नास्ति. सो द्विविधः प्रतीयमानः. In Kavi Prakasham, I think in fourth Ullasam or so, you will find that gudam, agudam, iti vyangyasya dvividaha bhedaha. So in the similar manner, he is saying here, dvividaha pratiyamanaha sputaha asputaha cha. It can either be sputam distinct or asputam. Tatra ya yaha yayeva sputaha shabda shaktya artha shaktya va prakashate sayeva dvanehe margaha na itaraha. Only though in those shlokas where the vyangyartha, the suggested, is put a clear either through shabda shakti or artha shakti, that is only considered as dhvani. Na itaraha, na itaraha ityukte yatra asputataya bhasate tatra dhvanehe margaha nasti. Asputaha api yaha abideyasya angatvena pratiyamanaha avabhasate. Yadi sputaha vyangyarthaha abideyasya vachyasya angatvena, if it only shines as something which is highlighting the vachyartham, which gives more beauty to the vachyartham and not the vyangyartha. Saha asya anuranana roopa vyangyasya dvanehe agocharaha. It is not considered as anuranana samlakshikrama vyangyam. Sputataya. स्फुटतया भासते अपि वाच्यस्य यदि अङ्गत्वेन प्रतीयमानः तर्हि न ध्वनेर्विषयः. सो हि गिव्स् एक्साम्पल्स् आफ् गुणीभूतव्यङ्ग्यं. टु एक्साम्पल्स्, फस्ट् वन् इस् कमलाकरा न मलिता, हंसा उड्डायिता न च सहसा, केनापि ग्रामतटाके अभ्रम् उत्तानितं क्षिप्तम्. अत्र हि प्रतीयमानस्य मुग्धवद्वा जलधर प्रतिबिम्बदर्शनस्य वाच्याङ्गत्वम् एव. सो the shloka, the meaning of the shloka is kamalakaraha na malitaha. So someone kenapi, some person grama tatake, in the village pond, someone has taken the abhram megha uttanitam kshiptam. He has turned it upside down and he has put it inside the lake. Kamalakara na malitaha, the lotus pond has not become dirty. Without making the lotus pond dirty, hamsaha sahasa na uddayitaha, uddayitaha nijantam, the swans have also not made to fly. So they have not disturbed the area in such a manner that the swans flew suddenly, or the water, when you put something inside the lake, it will make it dirty, right? When you suddenly put even a small stone, it will make ripples or it will make it dirty. But nothing of that sort has happened, and someone has somehow, by some cleverness, has taken the cloud and put it inside the tatakam. So grama tadage kenapi yuvakena abram megham uttanitam kshiptam. It is turned, been turned upside down and put it inside the lake. The context that Abhinav Gupta and Anandavardhana take here is some lady, she looks mugdha sa, she's very innocent, or she's like a fool, like a tube light we call in India, so cannot understand anything quickly. So she just looks at the lake and says, oh, how come there is a, you know, the cloud is inside the lake. So someone is saying, yes, yes, someone without dirtying the pond has just taken the cloud from the sky and just put it inside, upturned it and put it inside. So this is like, you know, teasing a lady and saying, yes, what you're seeing is someone has actually taken the cloud and put it inside. So that is how Anandavardhana and Abhinav Gupta have interpreted this shlokam. This comes in Gatha Saptasati. So the Pratiyamanartham here is we understand a lady who is very innocent and she is looking at the Jaladhara Pratibimba Darshanasya. She is looking at the reflection of the Jaladhara, of the Megham, and she is wondering what it is, and she is a Mugdha. So someone is actually saying, yes, yes, someone has put it inside without even disturbing the surroundings. So that Vachyam is more beautiful, and the Vyangya, Mugdha Vadhuhu Jaladharam, जलधरस्य प्रतिबिम्बं तडागे पश्यति इति व्यङ्ग्यार्थः वाच्यार्थस्य अङ्गत्वेन भासते. इट् आक्चुलि सपोर्ट्स् दट् प्रकरणं सपोर्ट्स् दिस्. सो इन् सम् आफ् द गाथासप्तशती इद् अदेन व्याख्यानं, some people have taken it as a girl who is talking, that sahasa in the idu adena, let me look at the text here. Vengama or nimsha, I'll pause this. See, the word sahasa in prakritam is actually translated in the Sanskrit chaya as pitrishwasa. He pitrishwasaha, Pitrishwasa is a father's sister, Atte. So one girl, who young girl who is going to meet her lover, she has asked that lover to come somewhere. She went to that tadagam. That tadaga is the meeting point, Sanketa Sthanam Atra. And she already went there. This fellow didn't turn up. Kamukaha Tatrana Agataha. later she is maybe in the well where they are taking water. She and her attai have come there, and she the boy she he went late to meet her, not finding her in that Sangeetasthanam. He comes to that near the place where she is standing with her relative, and he is trying to get her attention, but she is now angry. So she does not, she wants to somehow tell him that, you know, I went there and nobody was there. Instead of saying that, she's saying, you know, I went to that Tatagam and someone had put that Pratibimbam of a Megham there, so beautiful. And the Kamalakaram, the pond was also not disturbed. The Annapakshi also was there everywhere. And the place was not at all disturbed, which means it was such a calm place. He could have come there and we could have met each other. But he didn't turn up also. So she is expressing her anger towards the person who is probably listening there, the Kamuka who has come late and trying to find out if they can meet later. So she wants to convey her displeasure and she, in this form to her Atta. That is how the Gatha Saptasati has been commented upon by many commentators. So the context can be taken in many different manner. We will just take it as Anandavardhana here wants to highlight the Gunibhutattvam here, where he says the context is of a Mugdha who does not understand why this Megha Pratibimbam Atra Kimartham Asti Iti.
So Akka, in the second explanation that you gave, that second context, wouldn't that make it a Vyangya, a Dvani Shloka then?
Yes, it is.
Even in the first one, I did not understand why Gunibhutam, because after you explained the context, it still made, it still has a Vyangyartha, right?
Vyangyartha is there, but the Vyangya becomes an Angam to the Vachyam, where the Vachyam is more beautiful than the Vyangyam.
Oh.
That she is innocent and she doesn't understand why there is a, Megha Pratibimba Matra Kimartham Asti, someone has just put that Megham inside is more beautiful than the Mugdhata. Mugdhata is the Vyangyam.
Yeah.
Her innocence.
So isn't that more, after we know the Vyangyartha, isn't that more prominent or isn't that more dominating than the Vachyartha? I'm not understanding why Gunibhut, why this shloka is Gunibhutam.
The second one is so much better. The second shloka is better. That's why I also explained this dvani, to just say that it's more of a dvani shlokam for me than for a Gunibhutam. I understand your predicament here. It is a problem. Okay, in the first explanation, let me put it this way. Her mugdhata is just a vastu that is vyangyam. But teasing her in this manner, or saying that yes, what you are thinking is right. Adi, no, I feel that is more beautiful.
So yeah. Is this idu the narmokti madriya or it's kind of cute, that's all.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh, what is narmokti? The fact that person is saying, oh, this is just a teasing narmokti.
Yes. Oh. In a teasing manner, he is saying, how can she be like this? Okay, fine, let me play to your idea and say, yes, someone has done this. No? The way you say that is more beautiful than the Vyangyam of Mugdhata. Okay, she is innocent. And that innocent makes her believe this Vachyartham. That innocence becomes an Angam to this Vachyartham.
Oh.
See, that innocence is the Vyangyam here. Mugdhata is your Vyangyam. But that Mugdhata only aids this person to say this Narmukti here. Without that, this would not even hold good. And this won't be so beautiful. This is beautiful only because of that contribution. But that Mugdhata is not your more beautiful thing here. Abdi nedutun rome. Let's take it as. The next one is better. Sanketa Stanam Pratina Agatam. We have done that shlokam before. So what essentially here is tena na dvanihi so atrahi pratiyamanasya mugda vadvaha jaladara pratibimba darshanam she saw the pratibimbam of the megham that is the vach that is the vyangyam here she saw that pratibimbam is not so beautiful when you say someone has you know and in a teasing manner when someone says the megham has been put inside here without even disturbing the surrounding it's a adha and the cute expression da as she says the cute expression is more beautiful than the vyangya yeah the next let's go to the next one even if we keep
nariya and இந்த நல்ல உத்தம துவனி ஸ்லோகத்துலலாம் நிறைய சமயம் நீங்க சொல்ற மாதிரி அந்த தி சப்தம்ஸ் தட் ஆர் என்ன பிரயோகம் பண்றாரோ அது வந்து சில சமயம் ரொம்பவே மனோகரமா எல்லாம் இருக்காது இல்லையா சட்டுன்னு அந்த அர்த்தம் தானே இன்னும் மேலோங்கி நிக்கிறது அதே இந்த குணிபூத வியங்கியத்துல சில சமயம் முதல்லயே அந்த வாக்கியத்தோட அழகு
It'll just slap your face. The Vachyartham will be more... See, even after reading this slokam, you don't... Okay, let me give a contrast. Like, ipa Uma Mukhe Bimba Paladaroshte Paakarche. We continue to keep thinking about, you know, how even a great Shiva can be shaken. Adhudhani anga. Okay, so, that keeps on coming to our mind again and again. We don't keep thinking of the innocence of the girl again and again.
Okay, so the scene in that Bimba Paladaroshte, we think of the scene. Here, we just think of what he described.
Yes.
Or just words, maybe.
Yeah, the words. Kenapi abram uttanitam kshiptam. Someone just dropped it inside without even disturbing the surrounding. How can that happen? Okay. So that, the way he says it is more, it slaps your face, right?
Yeah.
okay. You keep thinking again and again, you come to the way he has expressed it. You don't think of, oh, she's so innocent. Huh? But she's so innocent that she believes even these words. That word is so beautiful.
Yeah, the fact that
come back to
her innocence again and again, I think that is the key point probably there.
Okay.
In the Shiki Pitcha Karnapura, and the இதெல்லாம் வந்து நீங்க எனக்கு சட்டுனா தான் தோணி அந்த ஸ்லோகத்துல அவ்வளவா இல்ல இல்லையா வாச்சியம்னு சொல்றதுக்கு ரொம்ப தான் பட் ஆனா வியங்கியம் வந்து நிறைய எடுக்க தோண்ட தோண்ட வந்துட்டே இருக்கு
just you can keep on thinking about all the different aspects that comes out there சிகி பிச்ச கர்ணபுராவுல
அது மாதிரி இது இல்ல இது
அந்த மாதிரி இது இல்லையே உனக்கு
இது ரொம்ப ரெஸ்ட்ரிக்டடா இருக்கு அப்படியே
ஆ தட் இஸ் வை வி டேக் இட் as a restricted in the restricted manner in which Anandavardhana has given us the context and Abhinav Gupta has given us the context if we look at Datta Saptasati commentators then it becomes so much more it becomes like Shikipichcha Karnapura but not Swatasambhavi but more like Vakthri Pravrutti
ஆமா அந்த மாதிரி ரைட் ஆமா அந்த இதெல்லாம் கூட முதல்ல படிச்சு அந்த சட்டன அந்த ஸ்வஸ்ரூரத்தில அந்த ஒண்ணு பிரம்ம தார்மிக விஷயம் அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் மாதிரி ஆயிடுது ஓகே
இல்லையா கவி பிரௌடோக்தி வந்து அதுல சாதர வீதீர்ண யௌவன ஹஸ்தாவலம்பம் சமுத் அது இல்ல பக்திரு பிரௌடோக்தி சஜ்ஜயதி ஆமா பக்திரு பிரௌடோக்தி இஸ் தட் யூ நோ அபியுத்தானமிவ உன்மத்தஸ்ய தத்தம் தவஸ்தனாபியம் தட் இஸ் தி எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஹி கிவ்ஸ் ஹியர் அதுதான் பக்திரு பிரௌடோக்தி அப்படி எடுத்துட்டோம்னா காதா சப்தஸ்ருதி காமெண்டேட்டர்ஸ் படி எடுத்தோம்னா தென் இட் இஸ் உத்தம துணி ஸ்லோகம்னு எடுத்துக்கணும் whereas we will just take it in this context
okay
okay
அது டிடிடியோட ஒரு இதுவா திஸ் காதா சப்தஸ்ருதி இது
இல்ல ஆர் இங்கிலீஷ் காமெண்டேட்டர் gives that
okay
டிடிடி doesn't give that நீ பார்த்தேன்னா விதிதி டசன்ட் ஸ்டேட் எனிதிங் ஃப்ரம் காதா சப்தசதி ஹி டேக்ஸ் இட் வெரி கிளியர்லி ஆஸ் ஹவ் ஆனந்தவர்தனா அண்ட் அபினவ் குப்தா ஹவ் டேக்கன் இட்
ஓகே ஓகே
அண்ட் இங்கிலீஷ்ல தான் ஹி கிவ்ஸ் காதா சப்தசதி காமெண்டேட்டர்ஸ் காண்டெக்ஸ்ட் அண்ட் சேஸ் பியூட்டிஃபுல்லி
சரி
அது எங்கன்னு பார்க்கணும். We have to take the original Gatha Sapta Sithi to find out what the context is to fix the dhvani. அவ்வளவு தூரம் பண்ணலாம். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், ஏவம் விதே விஷயே அன்யத்ராபி யத்ர வ்யங்க்ய அபேக்ஷயா வாச்யஸ்ய சாருத்வ உத்கர்ஷ பிரதீத்யா பிராதான்யம் அவசீயதே தத்ர வ்யங்க்யஸ்ய அங்கத்வேன பிரதீதேஹே த்வனேஹே அபிஷயத்வம். சோ ஏவம் விதே விஷயே, இன் சிமிலர் சிச்சுவேஷன்ஸ் ஆல்சோ, அன்யத்ராபி இன் அதர் ஸ்லோகாஸ் ஆல்சோ வி ஃபைண்ட் யத்ர வ்யங்க்ய அபேக்ஷயா இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் வ்யங்க்ய வாச்யஸ்ய சாருப்ப உத்கர்ஷா. So the vachyartha is more beautiful, utkarsha pratitya, and pradhanyam avasiyate. If it is more beautiful, then we'll have to come back to that vachyartha and that gains prominence. So pradhanyam avasiyate tatra vyangyasya angatvena pratitehe. It becomes an vyangya becomes an angatvam. So vyangyasya angatvena pratitehe, the vyangyartha becomes subordinate to the vachyartham. Dvanehe abhishayatvam, it is not treated as dvani. Yatha vetasa lata gahana uddina shakuni kula kolahalam shrungatyaha grihakarma vyapritayaha vadvaha sidanti angani. We've seen this shloka in Kavya Prakasham for gunibhuta vyangyam. Asundaram, where the vyangyam is not as beautiful as the vachyartham, the vachyartha is more beautiful. The vyangyam here is the prakaranam where datta sanketa chauryakamukaha saha agataha tatra sanketa sthanam prati chauryakamukaha sanketa sthanam prati agataha. So vadhuhu atra tasyaha angani sidanti grihakarma vyapritayaha, she is involved in grihakarma, doing her household work. Her angani sidanti, she is getting agitated and she wants to go and meet. Why? Shrinmantyaha, she is listening to the kolahalam, the sound that comes from the shakuni, the birds that are uddina, that are flying from the vetasa lata gahana. The in the bower gardens where there are many, the in the bamboo groves, the birds are all flying away from that bamboo grove and making a lot of noise. Shakuni kolahalam kolahalam pakshinam kolahalam shrunvatyaha shrutavati sa vadhuhu griha karmani vyaprita asti tasyaha angani sidanti. So the meaning here is, I'll read the lochanam easier. I don't have the mark correctly here. Atra datta sanketa chaurya kamuka rata samuchita sthana praptihi dvanyamana vachyameva upaskurute. So datta sanketa chaurya kamuka, chaurya kamukaya sanketam datta, tatra ratartham samuchitam sthanam saha prapnot. He came there, he has arrived. And because of his arrival, the birds have all started moving away from that place. They get disturbed and they're making a huge noise. She hears that. Now, the iti dvanihi vachyameva upaskurute tathahi grihakarma vyapritayaha iti anyaparayaha api. Even though she is involved in something else, the grihakarma vyaprita means she is involved in something else. So vadvaha vadhuhu iti satishaya lajja paratantrya baddhayaha api. She is vadhu, that is, she is just married, so she has lajja and paratantryam, she is dependent on other people because she is just married. Angani iti ekamapi na tadrika angam yatu gambhirya avahita vashena sambaritum paritam. Not just one body, one part of her body is agitated, that she can control it. Her entire body, she is not able to control the agitation or the eagerness that is there in her limbs. Sambaritum na paritam ityukte, she is gopaitum na paritam, she is not able to control herself. Or sidanti iti astam grihakarma sampadanam swatmanam api dhartum na prabhavanti. Sidanti means she is both mentally and physically, she is not able to control herself. So let that household work be? Let me immediately go. So she's agitation is revealed only in the Vachyartham, and that is more beautiful. So griha karma yogena sputam tatha lakshyamanani iti. Not because of griha karma, but because of that. Asmadeva vachyat satishaya madana paravashata pratitehe natu vyangena. Vachyena eva, vachyat eva asmakam pratitihi bhavati. Kasya tasyaha vadvaha madana paravashatayaha pratitihi bhavati. It is not kamukaha tatra sanketastanam agataha iti, that dvanihi does not give us her manmata avastha. It is only the words that are there in the shlokam that gives us her manmata avastha. So vachyam becomes more prominent here, and the dvani is not as prominent. Okay, idinna puriyirada?
Yes, Akka.
I think this is clear.
Yeah,
where the gunibhuta vyangyam is better. So gunibhuta vyangyasya api एवं विधः हि विषयः प्रायेण गुणीभूतव्यङ्ग्यस्य उदाहरणत्वेन निर्देक्ष्यते. दीस् आर् आल् द एक्साम्पल्स् दट् वी विल् शो फार् गुणीभूतम्. बट् समटैम्स् इन् द सेम् मेनर् वी विल् टेक् सो यु विल् हाव् अ वाच्यार्थम्, देन् यु विल् हाव् द व्यङ्ग्यम् विच् इस् द प्रकरणम्. दट् प्रकरणम् विल् गिव् यू एन् एडेड् मीनिङ्ग् टु द वाच्यार्थम्. आफ्टर् दट् वाच्यार्थ एण्ड् द प्रकरण व्यङ्ग्य इस् डन्, there will be so many other things that will come as a pratiyamanam. There it is dhvani, like kasyamana bhavati rosha. So kasyamana bhavati roshah drishtva priyayah sabranam adaram padmagrana shile sabramara padmagrana shile varitavame sahasvaidani. You have to tolerate that because you want to smell the flower which has a bhramaram, and your lips are all it has shows the bitten marks, or it is swollen because of that. So this, there is a vyangyam, there is a vachyam, and the prakaranam is a lady has gone and met with her lover and she has come back. So that prakaranam is actually vyangyam. It is not there mentioned in the vachyartham. After this vachyam and the vyangya prakaranam, there are so many different things that we understand as far as the sakhi's chaturyam goes, or for the husband, or for that prachanna kamukaha. Many different vyangyartha comes to our mind. The same manner he gives another shloka here. So the avatarika for that is evam vidaha vishayaha. In such cases, prayena gunibhuta vyangyasi udaharanatvena nirdekshyate. All the earlier shlokas are gunibhuta vyangyam. Yatra tu, in cases where prakaranadi pratipatya nirdharita visheshaha vachyaha arthaha. We have the prakaranam or the context pratipatti, the suggested, or by the understanding of the context, vachyartha nirdharita visheshaha, we have fixed the vachyartha. Punaha, again, pratiyamana angatvena iva avabhasati. So pratiyamanam prakaranam tasya angatvena avabhasati. Whatever the pratiyamanam that may arise after the prakaranam, so vachyam is there, you have the prakaranam which is pratiyamanam, and you have fixed the vachyartham here. After fixing the vachyartham, punaha, again, there are many different pratiyamanartha, and this vachyartha is actually an angam for the pratiyamana, different types of suggestions that can arise in everybody's mind. Saha asyaiva anuranana rupa vyangyasya dvanehe margaha. It is an arthashakti utbhava dvani. Or by the force of words, it can be either Shabda Shakti or Artha Shakti, depending on what gives rise to which pratiyamana. The example here is Uchinu Patitam Kusumam Madhunihi Shephalikam Halikasnushe Eshate Vishama Vipakaha Swashurena Shrutaha Valaya Shabdaha. As Akhi is saying this shloka, the meaning of the shloka is Patitam Kusumam Uchinu. Any flowers that have fallen down, you can gather those flowers. Gather any of the flowers that have fallen down. Halika Snushe, a farmer's wife. Halikaha is a farmer. Farmer's wife, you can pick up any flower that has been fallen down on the floor. Madhunihi Shephalikam. Shephalika is a type of tree. Don't dunihi, don't shake that tree. Yeshaha te valaya shabdaha swashurena shrutaha vishama vipakaha. If your valaya shabda, as you are, you know, as you are doing it and all, is something that is just prakarana vasham, that we will do it later. So the literal meaning here is, vachyartham is, te valaya shabdaha, your bangle sound, swashurena shrutaha, if it is heard by your father-in-law, vishama vipakaha, there will be a bad end to it. Vishama vipakaha, the result will be very damaging, right? Vishamaha, that is all is the vachyartham. Now from this vachyartham, what is the prakaranam that we understand? Avinaya patina saha ramamana sakhi bahihi shruta valaya kalakalaya sakhya pratibodhyate. The sakhi, a lady, Snusha, the daughter-in-law, she is being advised, pratibodhyate sakhya, by her friend who is waiting outside. Bahihi shruta valaya kalakala. Her valaya shabda is heard outside of that sanketasthanam, where she is with her avinaya patina saha ramamana, rahasya kamukena saha ramamana sakhi. Sakhya pratibodhyate, she is being advised by her sakhi. Now, pick up the flowers that are there on the floor. Do not shake the Shephalika tree. If your father-in-law hears the sound outside, then the vipakaha, the result will be very bad. Vishamaha bhavati. This is just the prakarana vasha. Prakaranam is vyangyam. Because of your valaya shabdam rahasya bangaha mahabhutu, people will know that you are with someone else or you are secretly meeting someone else here. The Shephalika tree is supposed to bloom only during night, it seems. So you go and pick up the flowers during the evening time. So it is a sanketasthanam. That sanketasthanam is a prakarana vashat. We understand that it is vyangyam from the vachyartham. But after this, there are different types of pratiyamanam that we understand. Avinayapati muddishya, what is heard? Yada shabdahana shruyate tatha bhuyaha. You have to behave in such a manner that the sound is not heard outside. Otherwise, people are going to suspect and come here. Sakhim prati, snusham prati, I have protected you today. Ensure that, you know, either don't go and meet him at all or try to keep your sound to the minimum. Swashuram prati, you know, if he is also hearing this sound, no, don't worry. She is halika snusha. You know, she does not know how to behave here. She does not know that it is an udyanam and you have brought up this tree in a very with a preeti yuktam. You love this tree very much. It is your favorite tree. I have told her, I have advised her, don't worry, she won't do it from now on. She won't shake the tree so much. She will only take the flowers that are fallen on the ground. This is for the father-in-law who might be listening. For us, sakyaha chaturyam, just like in kasevana bhavati rosha, or the prekshakaha. If we also, find ourselves in such a situation, we should have a clever sakhi to help us out of such situation. That is the vyangyam that is there for the sahrudaya or any prekshaka who is there. So, atrahi avinaya patinasaha ramamana sakhi bahishruta valaya kalakalaya sakhya pratipodhyate. Etad apekshaniyam. Etad apekshaniyam vachyartha pratipattaye. We need that context. Prakaranam apekshaniyam kimartham vachyartha pratipattaye. To understand the vachyartha, we need that suggested prakaranam or context. After that, pratipanne cha vachye arthe. This is very similar to the first vachyasi angam. Mugdatayaha pratitirvina abram uttanitam kshiptam tatage iti vachyarthasya. We will not be able to appreciate, or the beauty is more highlighted because of the vyangya mugdata. In the same manner, the beauty of the vachyartham is highlighted because of the prakaranam that is there as a context. So pratipanne cha vachyarthe tasya avinaya prachadana tatparyena abhideyamanatvat avinaya prachadanam. Whatever wrong she has committed, indisciplined action that she has committed, she is trying to, the sakhi is trying to prachadanam, she is trying to cover that illegitimate relationship. So abhideyamanatvat punaha vyangya angatvena angatvam eva iti asmin. So the vachyam entirely becomes an anger to the vyangyam, where which is an avinaya prachadanam. That is the tatparyam. That is the vatru vivaksha. Vyangya angatvam eva iti asmin anuranana roopa vyangya dhvanau antarbhavaha. In the lochanam he says atracha kasyamana bhavati rosho ityetadanusarena vyakhya kartavya. We have to understand, he doesn't give the vyakhyanam for the shlokam. He says as we have done the vyakhyanam for kasyamana bhavati rosho, you can take it in a similar manner. Okay, just the last two karikas, I'll quickly finish it off. Evam vivakshita vachyasya dvanehe tad abhasa viveke prastute sati avivakshita vachyasya api tam kartum aha. So just like how we have done it in for vivakshita anyapara vachya dvani, the same manner abhasa viveke prastute avivakshita vachyasya api, even for avivakshita vachya dvani we can apply the same thing, which is the lakshanamula dvani. Yeah. अव्युत्पत्तेः अशक्तेः वा निबन्धः यः स्खलद्गतेः शब्दस्य स च न ज्ञेयः सूरिभिः विषयः ध्वनेः. फॉर व्हेन वी वर लुकिंग एट द गुणीभूत व्यंग्यम ही गेव अस टू ऑप्शंस राइट. इदुदा यत्र प्रतीयमानः अर्थः प्रमलिष्टत्वेन वासते वाच्यस्य अंगतया वापि न असौ गोचरः ध्वनेः. इन द सेम मैनर हियर आल्सो ही इज गोइंग टू गिव टू वेयर अव्युत्पत्तिः अशक्तेः वा लक्षणामूलध्वनि शुड हैव स्खलद्गति. स्खलद्गति इज वेयर द प्राइमरी मीनिंग डज नॉट वी आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्राइमरी मीनिंग. वी नीड द लक्ष्यार्थ. वी गो टू द लक्ष्यार्थम एंड आफ्टर द लक्ष्यार्थम देयर इज अ vyangyartha. So either by avyutpatti, if the poet does not know how to if he does not have the correct skills, avyutpatti hi anuprasadi nibandhana tatparya pravrtihi. Let me take up diditi, which is a very good explanation for the karika. Avyutpattehe अनैपुण्यात् अनुप्रासादि निबंधन. I'm just reading out from here. अव्युत्पत्तेः means either because of a lack of nipunata, because he is using more of anuprasa etc. anuprasa nibandhana ekarasikatvat athava ashaktehe vritta paripurana samarthya virahat hetoho. If he does not know how to complete the meter or complete the poetry, this is ashakti, where he does not have the skills that are necessary for writing a shlokam. In that case skalagatehe lakshana baditarthasya lakshana gunavritti matra prayojya bodha janakasya shabdasya yaha nibandhaha yaha prayogaha sahaja dvanehe avivakshita vachya dvanehe vishayaha na gnyeyaha. If a poet does not have the nipunata, or if he does not have the pratibha or the shakti to give a shloka in such a manner that the lakshyartha goes further and gives us the vyangyartha, if that vyangyartha is completely absent and he is just concentrating on the skalagati, then it is not dvanehe vishayaha. You get it? In Lochanam, he gives two examples. I'm not going to go into detail with that example. We will just look at the text. Sarveshu eva pravedeshu sputatvena avabhasanam yat vyangyasya angibhutasya tat purnam dvani lakshanam. Sarveshu eva pravedeshu, in all of the different classifications, divisions of dvani that we have given, sputatvena yat vyangyasya angibhutasya vyangyasya yat sputatvena avabhasanam. If the suggested vyangya, which is angi pradhanam, that angi bhutasya ityukte charutvena yatra vyangyasya eva dvanehe sputataya charutva utkarshaha vartate tatraiva pradhanyam vartate tasyaiva angi iti vyapadeshaha. Tadrisha vyangyasya sputatvena yatra avabhasate तत्र सर्वत्र अपि सर्वेषु प्रभेदेषु अपि तत्र ध्वनेः स्फुटत्व अवभासनं वर्तते. सो तत् सम्पूर्णं ध्वनिलक्षणम् इस् जस्ट् वे इन् इन् एनी व्यङ्ग्यप्रभेदम् इफ् द व्यङ्ग्यार्थ इस् स्फुटत्वेन अवभासनम् then and it is angi, it is pradhanam, and that is where the charutva utkarshaha vartate, tad purnam, all of those prabedas, all of those different definitions can be taken as dhvani, that is your dhvani lakshanam, all of those prabedas are dhvani. Okay, will this tacha udahrita vishayam eva, he completes by saying tacha udahrita vishayam eva, we have given definitions for all of those prabedas, most of those prabedas. He is not given only for vastuna vastu, that he said you can find out wherever you have to look at the lakshya shloka and then find out which is the lakshanam for that lakshya shloka. Okay, with this the second udyota is done.